So in this video, I'm only going to show you the basics of soldering. This is not a specialized soldering video, but what I'm going to show you here will be enough for most types of soldering. A soldering station will really help you, because with the normal irons where you can't see the temperature, it's very difficult to set it correctly, and it's in most cases either too hot or too cold. Make sure you clean the tip of your iron regularly. Use the sponge at the top of your station. Just wet it a little bit and it will work perfectly to get you a nice and clean solder tip. Let's have a look at the settings of the station. You will see there's two settings. The one is read and the other one set. If you set it to read, then it will read the current temperature of the tip of the iron. If you set it to set, then you will be able to set your desired temperature for your iron. There's normally also an indicator light that shows you when power is applied to the iron and when it's busy heating up. You can see it on the right corner there. There's also normally a knob where you can change between degrees Celsius and degrees Fahrenheit, so you can set it to whatever you prefer. For general soldering purposes, I would suggest you set it to between 350 and 360 degrees Celsius. That will in most cases give you very good results. Vero or strip board is a very good choice for home projects, because you can use them without going through the etching process and you can build most of your projects on normal Vero board. It will help you a lot if your board is secured and it's not moving around while you're soldering. So clean your board with acetone or something like that. Make sure it's clean. Also make sure your component legs are clean. One of the biggest secrets in soldering is to make sure that the temperature of the track and the temperature of the component leg is correct before you apply your solder. So make sure that you heat up the track and the component leg before you bring your solder closer. Don't put too much solder. Too much solder will ruin your joint. A good joint is a joint that have a wet look and does not have too much solder on it. As soon as the temperature of the track and the component leg is correct, you will see that the solder will easily flow and cover the whole area. If that doesn't happen, then either your component leg or your track is not clean. You may not use the correct solder, or the temperature of your iron is too cold, or in some cases too hot. This was then the basics of soldering. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like it and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you and bye-bye.